Okay, now I've prepped my fletching material, all the feathers. What I did was cut a piece of the feather 3 inches long, approximately around there, three and a half. And I took my knife and split down the middle, which all that piece of feather there will give me two fletching materials. And then I cut another piece for the top, for another. You're gonna need a total of three. And at the end of each feather, I pulled some of the plumage out to leave an area where I can tie off each end using the cordage that I'm using. Each end would be tied off. And then once you put them together at the end of the notch or the knock area, they'll be tied off on each end where each. Okay, like I was saying, at the end of the notch, each part of the shaft is covered by 1/3 of each one of these fletching materials. So I'm going to go ahead and get the shaft set up for you so I can show you about tying the fletching onto the end of the shaft. Okay, what I like to do is start it with one feather at a time. I like starting with the top feather first, and that top feather you're going to put on so that it's in line with the bottom of your cut for the notch there. So basically, when you put it on, it's going to be going up and down like this. So the way I start is I take my cordage and I put a loop style slip knot, and I'll place it over. Then I'll start with the front tie off first. Once I have my feather basically lined up with the back of my notch, I'll go ahead and pull to where the string will tighten up on its own. And then once I've done that, it's a little windy out here, if I keep the wind down a little bit. Once I have that tied down a little bit, I'll loop a couple strands around it to keep it down, like so, to where it's tied off here. And then I'll do the same thing for the back. So if I show it like this, the top feather is in line with, once it will be as soon as I get it tied off. I will tighten the back the same way. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and place the other two feathers on and tie them down. The next feather will go here on the side, off-centered a little bit. Third one would go on the other side. Both ends will be tied down, and I'll come back and show you. Okay, I now have all three of my feathers on here. You can see top ones are lined up with a knock back here, which also will be lined up with the arrowhead tip I'll show you here in a minute. But you notice each feather is covering about 1/3 of the diameter of the shaft. But the most important part is to make sure that the top feather is lined up with the vertical direction of the notch. Okay? Each end was tied off with the cordage. If you even want to get more fancy than that, to keep this cordage on without unraveling, you can make your own wilderness glue out of pine pitch. You heat the pine pitch up and you mix it with the gray and white fire ash, and then once you put it on and it hardens, it's just like glue. Okay, next thing we're going to do is cover putting on your tip. Again, make sure when you put you cut your notch for your tip, it's going in the same direction as the notch where your string's going to be, or the notch where the string's going to be sitting. Okay, so make sure you cut that same notch. Let me stop the film here. Let me get some tips here, the different type of tips that you can use, and I'll be right back. Alrighty, I'm back again. I noticed St. Change of scenery. I had to pick up and move locations because while I was working on the tip of the arrow, violent winds started picking up and almost blew me and my camera away. So I had to switch locations, wait for wind to calm down a little bit, and I've completed the tip of the arrow using that quick set key. As you see, it came out pretty good. Now, once you make these arrows, you might get maybe 2-3 shots at the most out of them before they'll probably end up failing on you for some odd reason, either hitting a hard object or something. But you can use several type of materials for your shafts. Of course, you can use the mesquite root, the cattail, bamboo, straight reeds that you might find, anything, any type of seasoned straight wood that you can find. If it has a slight curve in it, you can heat it over fire without burning it, and once the wood heats up, you can hold it straight until it dries out or cools off, and it'll give you a good chance of straightening your shafts out. So hopefully you learned how to make your own arrows. Another post, I'm going to make a survival bow, show you how, so you can actually launch these arrows at something. Hopefully game or whatever you're going to use it for. And if you don't know how to use a bow and arrow, you're not proficient in it, go out and buy you an inexpensive one or whatever you want, and start practicing now. Because when you get out there and need the use of one and you don't know how, it's useless. So I'm even going to show you how to launch arrows using a slingshot method in a couple other posts. So hopefully you learned today. I'm Charlie, SwordOfSurvival.com. Stay prepared, stay alive.